Rwanda's central bank governor, Claver Gatete, was named finance minister in a direct swap with his predecessor, a move officials said was unlikely to cause a major policy change. We are now joined on the line by Governor Claver Gatete. Governor, thanks for your time. Did you expect the job?
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Were you surprised by the offer of the job? Did you expect it?
No, I didn't. I was busy with my job as governor of the central bank, but I was happy for the job since you see the field of economics, and I would take advantage to make my own contribution.
Absolutely. Now, that contribution is going to be, of course, watched by the markets. Now, you're coming into an economy that's growing 7% per annum. Of course, you have helped to reach that 7%. How do you take it further? What are your priorities when you come in?
First of all, really, it's that being at the central bank and the Minister of Finance, we've been working closely together. Mm. So, first of all, it's taking off from where my predecessor has reached, so that we really this time look at the economy in a different way, whereby we look at the new sources of growth, we look at the new sources of financing, we look at the new sources of revenues, we look at which areas can contribute mostly, especially to the export sector. How do we increase our base? How do we diversify the economy, I mean the exports, given the problems that we've been having in the Eurozone? Mm. What are the new markets that we can always expect? How do we work together to make sure that we can really concentrate our efforts on areas that can contribute greatest to the economic growth?
Yeah.
And that's where really we can work together as a team and be able to chart the way forward.
Yeah. So when you look at it, if you sum it up, then should we think of policy continuity here very much so rather than any radical change in terms of Rwanda's approach to economic affairs, first, of course, within Rwanda itself and also within the region and Africa?
Now, first of all, it's to do a kind of an assessment of what has been going on, because I was focusing on the monetary side and financial sector.
Yes.
But now it's going to assess exactly what is in place. Where can we focus on to make sure that we can have an impact, especially in the areas of infrastructure? Mm. So that we as a team, because it's not only the Minister of Finance, it leads but works together with other ministries and other institutions, and saying, what can we do differently to make sure that we can sustain our economic growth above 10%?
Yeah.
That's the whole idea, because our target was 11.5%. Mm. And right now, as you saw from last year's figures, in the first three quarters, we did extremely well.
Right.
7.5%, 9.9%, 3.3% in the third quarter, and now we expect to go beyond our initial target of 7.7%. Our numbers of GDP are coming up in a few weeks' time, early next month,
yeah.
And then we know exactly how we plan to grow and which areas we can focus on to make sure that we can contribute that growth.
Yeah. Since I've got you on the line, I'm going to ask you that question. What are you expecting in terms of those numbers next week for GDP?
Well, in any case, they are going to be more than 7.7%. Actually, our initial estimate was more than 8%, it was 8.1%. But we are waiting for the numbers to speak for themselves.
Mm.
And by the way, remember that this was achieved despite the suspension of some of the aid,
yeah,
mainly financed by the financial sector in Rwanda here.
Absolutely.
So you can imagine now we want to see what can we do differently,
sure,
to make sure that we can sustain our GDP growth in the area of above 10%, but also with low inflation.
Yeah.
Because at that point, we ended the year with 3.9% inflation, but at the same time growing at that high level of over 8%.
Right. Governor, two quick questions before you go. Number one, has President Kagame tasked you with increasing that rate of growth? And then secondly, in terms of your expectations for inflation going forward for the rest of the year?
Now, first of all, the president is leading the vision, and then the ministries work together. And as we work together as a team, we came up with a projection of 11.5% on an annual basis for us to be able to reach the upper middle-income country. And that's the target that we are working together. And working together as different institutions, but being coordinated by the Minister of Finance to achieve the President's vision. That is something that we share. And that's why we are coming up with a new poverty reduction and growth strategy for another 5 years that is going to grow the economy by that, at least on an annual basis, by 11.5%. This one's going to be launched, called EDPRS 2, its economic development and poverty reduction strategy. We've just completed 5 years. We are now starting another one for 5 years that's going to be unique in nature, where everybody's going to chip in, whether it is the economic ministries, agriculture, infrastructure, trade and industry, and the rest of it. Everybody's going to chip in. But we want to make sure that we also add value. How do we do? How do we work differently so that we can achieve maximum growth?
Indeed.
Where do we focus our efforts?
Yeah.
How do we prioritize?
Governor, we must get that uplink with Rwanda going very quickly, because there's a lot to be said here. But final question, and very quickly if you can, relations with donors.
Yes.
What are you going to do different to get them back on board?
Well, that's going to be my priority. My first, I think, work here is to make sure that I get on the phone, I hold meetings with the donors to make sure that we can see if we are really understanding the Rwandan situation together, especially those ones that are giving us aid, so that we see, is there anything else that is different that they want? Is there any way we can, how do we move forward together, despite what has happened in the past, is to establish a dialogue so that we can really understand the Rwandan situation together, and then see how we can continue to work together.
Absolutely.
We are partners, and it's very, very important that dialogue is very, very crucial.